Hi, my name is Marie Hines Cowan. I'm the chair of the exhibition committee and a board member of the National Association of Women Artists. And I'm very proud to welcome you to our 124th members exhibition. We just did some small interviews with our Medal of Honor winners, and I hope you enjoy them. Irene Nedelay here. She's the N.A.W.A. Medal of Honor and Elizabeth Stanton Blake Memorial Award for Oil on Campus. Do you find it easy to discuss what you're painting about? Do you think it's necessary to discuss it?
Sometimes. Yeah. Sometimes it bothers me because it looks like it's something like I want to tell something literally, verbally. But if I'm a painter, I need to say something by my paint, so mm-hmm. it's supposed to be enough, but sometimes I need to
go a little further explain it.
And for example, from time to time I made my exhibition in Germany, mm-hmm. and my picture about my grandmother, her cow, her dogs, which were kind of her family in Siberia, and they told me, the time is surrealistic painter, mm-hmm. but it's not true. I'm not surrealist.
So they were putting you in a genre, yeah. or a
yeah. type. They couldn't understand even this type of life in Siberia, in village, uh-huh. far from city, far from culture, far from civilization, without any roads. Mm-hmm. Like even now, I could reach my relatives in Siberia sometimes only in summer and winter, not in spring and autumn. Uh-huh. No roads to right. this place, so they don't understand it.
Right. So sometimes you need to go further than you can actually express in the artwork itself.
Judith Modrak, congratulations for winning the N.A.W.A. Medal of Honor and Margot Lieber's Harris Memorial Award.
Thank you.
And so why don't we talk a bit about your piece here and your feelings about being an artist. Why don't you tell us how you occupy that title of artist?
So I think being an artist is very much my core identity mm-hmm. in the world, even though it's obviously hard to sustain an art practice solely on one's work, and particularly in our country, artists are not supported financially as much as other professions. However, that said, I identify the passion of creating on a daily basis is what motivates me and mm-hmm. motivates me to wake up in the morning and to continue and to interpret the world through my various sculptures and other artistic manifestations.
So it's basically your reason for being.
Yes.
Aiko Aoyagi, who is the winner of our N.A.W.A. Medal of Honor and Amelia Peabody Memorial Award. Why don't you start off by telling us a little bit about the materials you used in creating this piece?
Okay, it's answer. Most important, plywood.
Okay, so you worked with plywood first.
I tried Home Depot, but feeling different. Then I used Japanese plywood.
Okay, so rather than American plywood, you used Japanese plywood.
Okay. The next, carving tools, most important for me.
Yeah, the actual tools, yeah.
Also Japanese carving wood tools, this is.
So you use the wood carving tools from Japan as well.
Also next, ink. What kind of ink is much better for this print? This is French charbonne, black ink.
Right, very good quality.
Then I used first time. I never used charbonne.
Oh, okay.
But this time I tried the paper, Japanese rice paper, and the ink, tools. Three kind of combinations, good friend of each other. For me, this is a new experience.
I'm going to introduce Marie, who is head of the exhibition committee. We have to thank her and all of us. And she's going to announce the award winners and give out the awards. So
I'd just like to welcome you all here. Thank you for coming. And thank you for celebrating our 124th members exhibition. And now I'll do what we've all been waiting for and introduce all the prize winners.
So we have Esther Berman here. She's one of our National Association of Women Artists Medal of Honor Award winners for the 124th Members Exhibition. What do you think about having been involved in this group, in this artist group, this women's artist group?
You mean here?
Yeah.
Oh, well, I was here last year.
In the exhibition.
And whether I'm in it or not, I just love looking. And I feel each piece is very important.
Well, yeah, to the artist individually, but also as a group, since it is a group for women's artists,
and
it's important for us.
As a group, the whole thing is beautiful.
Yeah, it is.
Definitely. Yeah. It's so exciting. I will come in here and not look too much, but it is like, I can't help it. I get very excited.
Well, that's great. That's
great. I don't show it, but I...
Okay. I hope you enjoyed the interviews. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you all at our 125th anniversary exhibition, and please visit our website.